There are some cool features added which will make it a lot easier to edit your photos in Lightroom version 10. Today we'll go through a few of these. This is Nagesh and welcome to NavEdits. The first thing that stands out is the new option in the Remove tool. Along with the generative AI feature, they have introduced something called Detect Objects, which is honestly a game changer. Basically, it helps detect the shape of an object automatically, making it a whole lot easier to get more accurate results. Instead of struggling to fine-tune your selections, you can just circle or scribble over an object, and the tool does the heavy lifting for you. This certainly saves time if you have weird shaped objects that doesn't always work with only generative AI option. So let's say there's this small rock pillar messing up the view of some nice flowers in your shot. You just scribble over it. Don't forget to include the shadow of the object too, and within seconds, it's gone like magic. The results look great and rock blends out so smoothly that you would never know it was there. I decided to try it again, and you can actually see how the tool adjusts the shape of the selection because it detects the object for you. It's smart like that. It even makes the selection slightly bigger to ensure everything blends in nicely with the surroundings, so there aren't any harsh edges or weird spots. You could also just circle the object and you'd still get the same seamless and natural looking result. It's one of those tools that makes it easy to go from a before full of distractions to an after where everything looks clean and professional. A few times I tried, it will try to replace the object with some others, so better to just disable detect objects and just use generative fill to completely remove it. This happens only sometimes. Now let's talk about the suggested edits with quick actions, which are still in beta but worth checking out. You can enable it under the early access tab. I got this image of a person and I'm going to give quick actions a shot. The first time you use it, it gives you a little overview of how it works. Basically, it analyzes the image for a few seconds and then offers some pre-made selections, so you don't have to do any manual masking, which is a huge time saver. I'm starting with the subject selection. It's really cool because the presets only affect the subject, leaving the rest of the image untouched. Once you tap on the preset, you can even adjust the intensity to get the exact look you are going for. It's a simple way to make your edits feel more polished without spending ages tweaking every little detail. Now let's move on to the background option. As you'd expect, this one focuses only on the background, leaving your subject untouched. It's pretty handy because you can tweak the background without messing up the main focus of your shot. You've got options to change the type of blur. So if you want a soft, dreamy look or something a bit more dramatic, you can easily adjust that. Plus, you can dial up or down the intensity of the blur to get the exact effect you're after. There are also a couple of sliders to play with, letting you adjust the exposure and saturation of the background separately, which is super useful. This feature alone can save you a ton of time, especially when you're trying to get that perfect balance between your subject and background without having to manually mask and tweak every detail. It's one of those tools that just makes the whole process feel smoother and more efficient. Now let's dive into the retouch option. This is where it gets interesting because the tool automatically creates those selection masks and you can go through them one by one to make more focused edits. I'm going to start with the clothing. There's a simple slider that lets you either enhance the colors and textures or dial it back for a more subtle look. The difference is pretty noticeable and it's really cool to see how much control you have over these smaller details. You also get separate masks for other areas so you can edit each part of the image individually, which is super convenient. I'll try this feature on a different image. That's a better example to show it off. Once the image is analyzed, the tool identifies all the areas you can retouch. Hair, skin, eyes, teeth, clothing, basically anything that needs a little polish. What's great is you can fine-tune each area independently. For instance, the hair mask lets you either add more detail for sharpness or smooth it out for a softer look. Then there's the teeth whitening slider, which lets you adjust how bright you want the teeth to be without going overboard. The eyes have their own enhancement too, so you can give them that extra pop. And the skin slider is pretty flexible. It can either smooth out the face for that polished look or add some texture if you want a more natural feel. You can make all these subtle improvements without spending hours manually adjusting every little thing. Other than these game-changing features, there are also some adaptive presets added to the already growing presets list. Hope this video was useful to you all and subscribe for more. We'll get back to you soon. Thanks for watching.